Alright, so especially because our choir friends who are out singing and making beautiful noises. I like saying beautiful noises because it sounds like an oxymoron. Because normally noise is not part of it. But alright, we are spending some time today working on the Y-Pi activity because we didn't really get to, like, the gist of it yesterday of, like, how it proves. And I think I forgot to show your class the video. So we'll see if I am able to show this video now that I started recording and not get pinged. But we'll see. If they pull down my video, I'll just deal with that and take it down. But in Schoology, you do not have to go to Schoology. I'm just saying this so you know it's there. In Schoology, which it's going to take me a moment to get logged in over there. I have now at all, don't make me two-factor. Please don't make me two-factor. What if I say please? Hey, it let me in. Alright. In our Schoology page, now I can guess what vote you're going to make, but if you go to the geometry folder, would you like the just regular video or the one with the epic soundtrack?
Epic soundtrack.
Okay, I figured as much. Alright, what did we make? Y'all are so smart. Alright, so a little hard to see because my little recording frame, which actually maybe will... I'll see if I can pause this and then restart it. All right, so if you are watching the video from home, what you just missed is our epic journey cutting this circle into lots and lots of pieces and piecing it back together to prove through a rectangle how we develop our circle area formula. Now we're getting to the Desmos Y pi to talk about that reasoning for how we get to the circle formula. But just to give you a little taster, if you are thinking about coming to Math Counts this week, here's the sort of problem that we would be solving at Math Counts. I'm trying to get securely up so I can pause your computer so we can talk about Math Counts for a minute. Yeah, so if you're going to be mad at me when I pause your computer, here's your warning. Your computer's about to get paused.
Oh, gosh darn it.
All right, so we do not have to solve these problems right now. I just want to give you a taster of what Math Counts is like. Gerald is going mini golfing with his family. For the five of them to play, it cost $34. They were charged for two adult tickets, three student tickets. If each student ticket is three-fourths the price of an adult, how many of each ticket did they purchase? So again, Math Counts is very much like just play with math, try different strategies, see what other people did. But then I like this problem a bit more because it deals with the windmill holes, which are always the fun one. So then the next hole, because there were multiple problems, I just pulled a couple. Go ahead and read this for a second. I feel like it'll be better if I shut up for a moment. With what we're learning yesterday, so I guess what we learned, you know what you need to know to figure out this problem. Anyone want to tell me what they think we would probably do first?
Well, it says if the end of each blade is 6 inches and the distance from the center of the fan the end of a blade is 3 feet, since it's 3 feet radius.
So this is 3 feet, correct?
Yeah, no, I don't know.
Vivian? Not area here. Harrison?
Just a question about it. Does the number of the blades matter or no?
The number of the blades does matter. Good thinking here. Kyrie?
You can find the
Not the area. Does this part of the circle, like right here, can this block your ball?
No.
So really only like the edge of the blade, the very like tip of it, could block your ball, Vivian? Ooh, so we need to figure out what the circumference is. Okay. And then what would we do?
Harrison? Divide it by the length of the end of each blade times amount of the blades.
Ooh.
And then divide that number by the circumference, which I'm doing right now.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blades. So there are 5 blades. Each of them are 6 inches wide. How much of your circumference is blade? 30. Well, 30%? Yeah, where'd you get that word percent? I don't know why you're talking about that. 30 centimeters of our circumference. How would we figure out circumference? What's our circumference formula?
Pi
times diameter. What would the diameter be here?
6 feet,
because if the blades are 3 feet long, so pi times 6, or about 18.84, I think. I've just memorized these over like a decade of doing this.
It's 18.84955592.
What did we do wrong here? We fell in a trap door. This is the sort of trap door you gotta watch out for at Math Counts.
Oh.
I used 6 and I used 3. What trap door did I fall into? What's the label on the 3? What's the label on the 6? If I use 6, I cannot use 3. I should be using 36 inches, or I should, instead of 6 feet, how many inches are in 6 feet? 72. Our diameter there would actually be 72 inches. So there's lots of layers you got to pay attention to when you're doing a Math Counts type problem, but it's really, really good for our brains. Pardon?
Why does it say 36 inches?
Because that's how much blade we figured out. Because if there are 6-inch blades and there are 5 of them,
it should say inches, right?
Yeah, sorry, my brain was still in 7 meters from last class. The problems we were doing there was all in 7 meters. Like, I love when you guys find my mistakes. I wish somebody had figured out the trapdoor with inches feet, because that one was more in our face. But yeah, so that's a Math Counts type of problem. So if you are interested in solving problems like that, 8 a.m. on Friday, come to this door right by Mrs. Denise's room. Come there, and we'll do some math. 8 a.m. on Friday. We will have donuts. All right, so now what I need you doing is the Y Pi, and then the area challenge activity. Everybody, I believe, needs to go back into YPI. I'll check it and see if anyone was far enough that I can just be like, yeah, you're done now. But I think we all had more work we needed to do. So it looks like I'm waiting for some of us. You should be unpaused. Let me know if for some reason it's not unpausing you. Nolan, be careful. I think you were just using like 3 times diameter on a couple things that I'm looking at here. Just be careful to actually care about the accuracy. A couple of us, Rowan, Kira, Chase, look like we've skipped slide 3 by accident. So make sure you actually complete what the slides are asking. It might be good for all of us to just start back at slide 1 and see if we actually did them. Yeah, Rowan, what you're looking up, if you look at graphs of proportional relationships, I think that would help you. All right, I'm just going to give you guys a few minutes to work on the Desmos and try to not interrupt you. What's up? Absolutely. As long as it feels like a good time to go, you don't really have to ask me. You can just sneak out. I pay attention enough to see when people are leaving, and I would tell you if it was a bad time. So guys, with so many people gone for choir, I know it's kind of awkward, but essentially I just want you to work through YPI to get a little bit of that knowledge. Because I'll be straight up with you, it was at least high school, maybe college, before I really like could write the proof of why a circle's area is pi times radius squared. We just got told just memorize it. It just is what it is. Just memorize it. So through the YPI activity, hopefully as we start to do this slide and do more with this slide, what shape are we forming? Essentially, a triangle. And how do we do area of a triangle? Base times height. So if we analyze the base compared to the height, we can also work our way to a proof. Why is it pi times radius squared?
So area is just radius times
circumference. No, that is not what I said. And that does not come out to be the same. If I roll this back up, right, this outer edge is our what? And this from the center out is what? When I think of area of a triangle, it's base times height divided by 2. So it's half the circumference times radius. Pull out yesterday's notes if you need. That's why we took notes yesterday. Ah, those papers. The trees we killed. Yeah. Screencast-O-Matic, I think, is still its name. Yeah, I paid for it. But this, so version 2.3.9, but because it lets me do multiple recordings at the same time, so like one can be uploading and the other can be recording. Hey, so I'll ask this question under the pretense of I am still recording. Any shenanigans would be captured by the screen recording. Can I trust you guys? I'm going to tell another teacher to keep an eye over here. But can I trust you guys while I run to the restroom?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, I figured I could. There's like only half of you here anyways. Thank you.
5 times R as 45. That's for an inch.
So you just do your radius times, so like it's worse than 7, you 7 times 7, pi. So like 40 times pi. That's so easy. Right. Right.
All right, so if you think you're relatively comfortable with like, okay, I get it, pi times radius squared, there are ways we can prove that. We could make it into a rectangle by doing pizza slices. We could make it into a triangle by just unrolling and stacking the whole thing. So now to look at some weirder situations, let's all jump out of YPy and go look at the area challenges assignment. And I would love for you guys to chat with each other while you're doing this because you are all looking at the same slides. So unlike Khan, when you have different stuff, you all have the same things in Desmos.
Thank you.
Alright. One B is you guys, right? Inquire. Oh my gosh. Aranya, you want to talk to us about what you thought for this? Which shape is bigger that it looks like we are all past now? Sorry, you said which one do you think is bigger?
B.
B? Okay, Carter, what are you thinking? You think B. Harrison, what do you not hear? Will not hear. Lila, what are you thinking? Oh, sorry, I'm thinking my other Harrison who's in the afternoon class, and he is not here because that's not his class. Harrison, what are you thinking?
So B, can I explain?
Yeah, well, let me ask a couple more people, then we can get back to you. Nolan, what are you thinking? Saying B. Kira? Okay. So Harrison, what are you thinking?
So so you have some A and B both have all of the quadrant shapes, the same size and same shape.
So hold on. I think you just said four of the quadrant shapes. Say that differently. What do you mean?
Four
circles. So Harrison identified there are quarter circles here. Approximately 1, 2, 3, 4 of them.
On each one, so we can factor those out, because it's going to be the same value added. And then A has three squares.
Not half squares. Sorry, go ahead.
And A has three squares, and B has four squares, so B is more because it has more squares.
Now, if you did not make the realization of these are quarter circles, that might be tough. They are definitely not half squares. And then if you want to justify how are they different than half squares, then we get on to the next slide and we get asked, well, what is the area there? So if we're using a scale of 1, not terrible, we could say, okay, if the radius was 1, and if I have all my half circles, or all my quarter circles, they could actually combine back to make a whole circle. So if I do radius of 1, what's my area formula? Anyone? Aranya?
Pi
times radius squared, or yesterday we said we could also write it radius squared pi, because if we want to leave it in pi terms, all we got to do is figure out what our radius squared is. What's our radius squared here? 1, right? Because 1 times 1 is 1, so this circle area would actually be pi, but then we have 1 more, 2 more, 3 more. So it's really like 3 plus pi, or approximately 6.1415, right? It's going to go on forever, but centimeters squared. Now be careful. On the next slide, we change our scale. Now our scale is that every box is 6 centimeters, and that math will not work out as easily. Also, what's different about this one? How much, Rowan, how much of the circle do we have? We have a half circle because we had 2 quarter circles, right? As you get into con, it's going to be things like this with partial circumference and partial area. You just got to be careful, like, how much of the circle do we actually have? Questions? I want us to all get to this point to talk about what mistake was made. I'd like us to all be past this slide. So if you do slide 2 on your own, you should be able to figure out what Taylor's mistake was. Don't worry, it's not Taylor Swift. She can't make mistakes. Kyrie, can you spot what Taylor was trying to do and how they goofed it up?
I don't know what she was trying to do, but she messed up because she,
See, that's funny. I assumed Taylor was a boy since he made a mistake, but...
Whatever. I don't care. Oopsies. And,
did you do the slide before this, where we just figure out, like, what the area is?
Yeah.
Okay. How did you do this slide? Let's go, let's forget about Taylor. How'd you do this?
Math.
What math? Say more.
What did I do? That's a good question. Because I did like 6, and then I times that by, and then I squared it, and then I times that by 5.
Okay, well that gives us 36 pi. So this is 36, this one?
Uh-huh.
Okay, centimeter squared, right? Madeline, can you spot Taylor's mistake? We haven't figured it out yet. We got to 36 pi, but that's what Taylor has on the next screen.
So, what Taylor did is she calculated it so if you combine those two together, you get a half circle. Taylor calculated it as a big circle.
36 pi would be the entire circle. So Taylor got excited and they're like, oh, I got the answer. And they forgot, how much of a circle do I have here? A fourth, right? So what's a fourth of 36 pi? 9 pi, right? So this should be 9 pi, and what should the green space be? Also 9 pi, right? So Taylor just forgot to quarter up the circle, and therefore got an answer that is too big. All right, have a great day, guys. It should be 18 pi plus 36. Hey, be careful. Pi terms and constants can't be added. You would need to switch your pi term into a decimal if you want to be able to add it up. Otherwise, it works like terms, right? Pi terms work like terms. Yeah, pi is kind of... So pi is not a variable, right? It's not a variable, but it kind of works like one.
Do you see?